Today I'll be talking about the use of open access repository on Sci-GaIA project or Sci-GaIA platforms to promote the content of innovations. So actually eLabs is a social innovation hub that is using innovation to reach out to vulnerable youth and help them to design practical solutions to address the various social challenges in their local communities. In that sense, youth all they come to increase their employability and create opportunities for self-employment. But also, eLabs provide the space for community members to reconnect it to their communities and improve the regain of sense in and get like the future, see the world of opportunities in social innovations. So having that in sense, the Living Lab is end user centered. It uses the bottom up approach in solving community challenges, in a sense of like we bring the community together, we bring end users together, we set them in the space to help each other to identify the solution in their communities. But from that, then they design a practical solution, and that's where they start working with the solutions to address the ideas. So now, what comes out of all the co-creation programs between the end user communities and innovation stakeholders is like they come up with the innovative products, innovative services. They might change the process that is existing. Something that comes also is like innovative business models, innovative policies, but also they can adapt the existing policies in the sense of how to change to better match the market, but also address the social challenges or create opportunities for employment. So the idea is when you have the innovative ideas in the community, we have the social challenge solution. What is happening? We try to help youth to commercialize the innovations, but also to commercialize the skills that they develop in the space. So in that sense, we have a different groups of people or communities that we work with. We work with primary school and secondary school leavers and dropouts, but also we work with out of school and unemployed youth. And also we work with adults in the space. So actually is letting these people together in the space and just work together and co-creating the innovations. So having that on platform, we have the program called the Open School. So here the Open School has got, is meant to address the challenges, and it does three components differently. One component is academic, and second is vocational, and the third is generic. So actually the Open School was brought into the concept where out-of-school youth, school dropouts, unemployed youth may come, but they don't have qualification to join formal education. So in the sense, we came up with the idea of bringing in the open school concept, in the sense, those who join the program at our school, in this open school, after 2 years, they get a qualification to join formal education, and also they get a qualification to join the formal employment systems. And the idea actually was accepted by the government, and the students that join these programs, they get accredited by the government through the Institute of Adult Education. So now we feel of being happy because actually the system has brought the impact and has been accepted by the national systems. So actually the academic skill of the academic component of the open school is meant for placing the participants in formal education and later informal employment system. And the vocational and the generic skills, they are run in form of like, they develop in a sense of like addressing a certain challenge. So they are like a project-driven learning, but also challenge-driven learning platform. So these participants, they come to the space, they work in groups by identifying the challenge in the community, and they work in specific groups with the diverse fields, in a sense like what they want to do, they need to develop a solution for a certain challenge. When they have the solution, they have to commercialize the solution. And after their graduation, they graduate with the skills, hands-on skills. They graduate also with the projects, but the projects are registered as social ventures or social enterprises. So at the end of the day, the graduates have to move with the business out of the school. So we have the incubation program with these guys who have the ideas. And then from there, we feel of like these out of school youth, they get their stepping stone back into the system of sustaining their life. But also on the vocational, we have actually right now the information technology, electronics, carpentry, sewing and needleworks, electrical installation, and motor vehicle mechanics as trade test for those guys who come to join. And actually, we don't design what program to do, but the program are designed themselves automatically depending on the users that are coming to the space according to their passions. So today, maybe in 2 years, we might have motor vehicle mechanics, but after 2 years, then the participants have other passions. So we don't do, again, motor vehicle mechanics, and we don't focus on that. We focus on end user requirements. So we have the innovations and the products, also the services that always comes out of the space and out of the activities. And some of them are like, you see, there was a problem with, we live, the hub is located around Lake Victoria. So there is waterborne diseases, it's like skin diseases. They were affecting a number of people, children that they go to swim along in the lake. So the disease were too chronic, but later in the space, they came up like a group of people want to solve the challenge. They came up with innovation. They designed how to come up with a petroleum jelly, like a Vaseline, that also addressed the challenge. And it came out and it is now working and it's in the market. So, and by this year in July, we shall have the graduation for these guys, and they move out with a prototype of their business, and it's in the market now. They can have the small industry working. But also we have other innovations. It's like we have the plastic water bottle reuse. These plastic water bottles, they are being used, they are thrown, and they don't decay. They don't decompose easily. They pollute the environment. So the idea is using these materials to make something usable and make something that can change life of people. So actually, the first prototype of the use of this bottle were like building the water tank. It's 2,000 liters actually, in one of the old woman and in a community to help her like collect the harvest rainwater. So after looking at the strength of the tank, then it comes out the idea of building the houses that is using the water bottles. And you can see this is our social enterprise. It is located in our area in town that we use it as a shop for graphic design, printing, photo studio and stuff like that, and ICT solution for local people. But it is built by the bottles from bottom to up. And you can see like at this space, these are just, you can see the bottles, but all the space is built by bottles. So it's one of the innovation. And now like there are three customers, they want to build the houses, they are collecting the bottles, and it can be a business for the guys who came up with the innovation. So we have a number of innovations like actually in the space for guys that they are working, but we, having that in all of the innovations, we came up to understand now, what should we do? The challenge is like, we believe an African context, most of African communities, they have or they suffer from almost the same community challenges.
And when the solution developed on at one place and then is shared, it can be used to address challenge, the same challenge in other community. So having that in sense, most of these hubs that are out of the city, they don't have infrastructure, they don't have internet connectivity, or this is limited, then they might have local solutions that might be very useful to other communities, but they are hidden. And these local communities, they don't communicate these innovations and these solutions. So the idea was like using the open access repository on Sci-GaIA platforms to promote these innovations, to bring them to the people, to bring them online, to be accessed for free, so that people could learn from other communities, or the solution could be replicated to somewhere else to solve challenges in that areas. So with the idea is the role maybe could be sharing or uploading digital formats of the successful stories. It might be maybe articles, successful articles of the innovations, maybe audio recordings or videos or documentaries actually, so that people could learn from the innovations and think of doing that. But also in the open school, we have developed the curriculums. We collaborate with universities in different in Tanzania, like the Dar es Salaam Institute of Technology. We work with Institute of Adult Education in Tanzania. So in that sense, we work together to develop the curriculum that are non-formal to support these guys who are in a non-formal education system. And then these things could be uploaded online and then in on a Sci-GaIA open access repository. So then applicability and replication of the impact could be shared and could be used somewhere else. Thank you and welcome.
Thank you very much, Carol.